smelled so bad when I first took it out of the packaging, and it still smells. I don't really like that look. I think it looks very weird. Almost immediately after I sent the links for two items, they were unavailable. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kayla Rose and this is my channel. So today I'm going to be doing another Yesstyle video. I'm in an ongoing sponsorship with them, so I'm going to be testing out more of their clothes, except this time I'm doing a lot more clothes that have no reviews on them, so I think it'll be a little bit more interesting. Hopefully it helps you guys out, so let's just get into it. All right, firstly is this Sonora short sleeve dotted mini A-line dress. This is one of my favorite things that I received because it's very flattering towards your body. I've seen a lot of other reviews do this as well. So this one does have reviews on it. It has like 30, I think. For the most part, it's really snug on my body, but not in a way that makes me feel really uncomfortable with it. Overall, I think it is a really adorable dress for fall time, but you can also sport it in summer, seeing as it is like light chiffon-esque material. It makes it very flowy and easy to wear. So you can wear this without a bra or anything underneath, and you're pretty safe. And then there's a zipper in the back, so it's really easy to get on and off. So this is one of the items that has no reviews on it because it is classified as a new item, and it is from Honey Diary long sleeve knit cardigan. I just adore the look of big buttons on clothing, especially for fall time. It just makes it look so much cozier for some reason, and I'm not sure why, but anyways. The color is very neutral. I feel as though it will go with a lot of pieces that I already own. It is a very thick, good quality sweater. It is a tad bit itchy in the sleeve length. So it fits me how it fits on the model, but it looks really weird in person. Almost as if it was supposed to go the full length up to my wrist, but then it just got cut short. So it almost looks like it's too small for me. I don't really like that look. I think it looks very weird and toddler-ish. Another thing I'd say about this item is that it smelt so bad when I first took it out of the packaging, and it still smells. It's so potent. I have no idea what kind of smell it is. It's just like musk. So be wary of that. So next is the Honey Diary lace blouse slash plaid A-line pinafore dress. I thought I only got the pinafore dress, but I guess I got the shirt as well. So I'm gonna be reviewing both of them. So I was really iffy about the dress because a lot of the reviews said it was too short on people, even though they're like 4'11", and I got really nervous because I'm 5'3". I don't like it when things are too terribly short because then I don't ever see myself wearing them out in public. However, what I did was I just took a measuring tape and I measured how long the dress would actually fit me if I got it, and it seemed like it would fit fine. Another big issue that people seem to have was that the bust was too small, that it would like pull the buttons apart. I did see that it was pulling on the buttons a little bit. Like when you see it off, you look, oh yeah, that'll totally fit me. There's enough room in there. And then once you get it on, it's like, why is the button pulling apart? I actually really like the way this dress fits my body and how long it is. I don't think it passes the fingertip test if you wanted to wear it to school. So you might want to wear like tights underneath it or leggings. But yeah, overall, I really do like this dress. It's super adorable. And then I'm gonna talk about the shirt that I wasn't expecting to get, but I did. I thought it looked a bit cheap just because it is very see-through, and I thought it would be itchy and not of good quality, but once I put it on, it's not scratchy, so that's always a good thing. I'll wear anything as long as it's not scratchy. I love the sleeve details where it has the little bow at the end and it frills out. I think that's so adorable. And I really, honestly, I was not expecting to like this shirt. I'm very, very pleasantly surprised. I wish I wouldn't have gotten so many shirts because I wasn't expecting to receive one to go underneath that dress, which is why I got this shirt. Honestly, the shirt is so comfortable. It is very, very see-through. That's why I got it to put underneath other items. But for the most part, this shirt is really soft and the neck doesn't choke you. It has the like lettuce detailing around the neck and the sleeves and also the bottom. I like plain basic t-shirts, and I really liked this one. I like the simple design on the front. It's not soft. It's wearable, but it's just not as soft as I thought it was going to be. Overall, the length is decent. Ivy and pine, I think that's what that says. It almost looks like it's supposed to be distressed, but it's not, so it's kind of throwing me off. I think it's a nice plain t-shirt. Next is this Vicky frilled Peter Pan collar blouse in white. You could wear this to a business meeting, but then you could also wear it like underneath that chunky knit sweater and have it be like a cutesy girly look. I wouldn't mind wearing a sports bra underneath it because it's not so sheer to where I'd feel uncomfortable just wearing that underneath. However, you could also wear like a spaghetti strap underneath it. The cuffs on the sleeves are nice and thick, and it comes with two buttons that you can unbutton if you want to. Yeah, easy to dress up or dress down. I enjoy it. So this is where things get a little bit confusing. Almost immediately after I sent the links for two items, they were unavailable. So I was wondering, am I going to receive the items? Do I talk about them if they do show up? Because if they're unavailable, what the heck am I doing showing products that aren't even available anymore? So I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing right now. So this was called the Sonora Spaghetti Strap Plaid A-Line Dress. I'm not going to talk about this dress a lot because I don't even have a link for it. Like, I didn't get provided a link to show you guys. I'm just gonna show you it and move on. This dress that's black with red and green stripes running through it. It's plaid, has like frilly detailing at the bottom. It's cinched in at the top, but then it flows out. So it's just the perfect dress. My boobs are too big for the boob cups, but whatever, that's fine. I was somewhat anticipating that anyways. It's really cute, and I'm really disappointed that I don't have a link to show you guys because I feel like a lot of you might have liked this dress. I have no idea what happened, so I'm really, really sorry. DIYI plaid high waist lace-up shorts in the color almond, and I got a size large because that's what I would fit after I measured everything out. And it looks like they'd be cute, right? I don't like them at all. In fact, they're so stretchy at the band, I honestly think I could have afforded to size down and it might have looked a little bit better. I don't think I like the paper bag style where it like flares out at the top. I'm too squatty to like pull it off. It just goes up way too far. It sucks because the color's really pretty. It is just as depicted on the website. And then it has like dark brown thread running through for like the stripes. It seemed like it would be such a cute design, but it just looks horrible on me. Tis what it is. This is another item that I'm very iffy about, and I'm not sure if I like them or not, to be completely honest. They're the same material as that plaid jacket that I got, where it's pretty scratchy and I don't like wearing it. However, it's not like that on the inside, so that doesn't bother me at all, except for the waistline. The leg holes are so wide in comparison to my leg that it just makes it look janky. I got it in a size extra large because, again, I measured myself and that's what I would fit as. And it does fit around my waist. I could have afforded to go a size smaller though, to be honest, because it is just, it's too big on me. This could be cute for someone, but I just don't think it fits my style personally. I feel like since I'm ragging on almost everything, it makes me sound like I'm ungrateful. I'm super grateful that I get to receive all these items, but I'm gonna tell it how it is. If I don't like something, I'm gonna tell you. I'm not gonna hold back my feelings. So next is this DIYI asymmetric single breasted plaid high-waisted A-line skirt. It's a lot longer than I anticipated. There's a lot of loose threads around the buttonholes, which makes it a little bit difficult to actually put the button through the hole at first, but once you get it, it's not that big of a deal. But yeah, there's just a lot of loose threads. There's no shorts on the inside. It doesn't have a lining. This material isn't the same as the other one, so it's not scratchy. I got this in a size large. I could have opted for a smaller size, I think. Threading through it looks like it has brown, black, red, a little bit of blue, but overall it just looks brown. So this is another item that I think was new and had no reviews, but got discontinued or something. Like, it's just not available anymore. So this is the Girl Supply lace-up black long sleeve bodysuit. This is another item that I'm not gonna talk about a whole lot just because I don't have a link for you guys to find it. I'm just gonna give you a quick overview. It's really silky. It's black, kind of reminds me of like pirate chic kind of look. You can wear it on your shoulders or off the shoulders. It has the cute lace-up ribbon in the back and the bottom clasps. That's pretty much all I'm gonna say about it. So the next thing is this Storyland hooded cape jacket. It is nice and thick. It keeps me warm. I'm actually wearing it because my room is pretty cold right now. I love the buttons. It's funny because the buttons are reversible. You could choose to wear it either overlapping from the left side, or you can change it to where it's overlapping from the right side because there's a buttonhole for each of them. There's a red lining around the hood, which I don't know why it's there, but I don't mind that it's there. I think it makes it stand out. I find it unique. The inside has a black lining as well, but then once you get to the sleeves, it's soft, so it makes your hands feel nice and cozy. Next up, I got these Agena lace-up short boots, and they look like this. And it's already starting to crease in the toe box area just because, you know, when you walk, the front tends to crease. They're slightly too big for me, so if you do want to get them, definitely stay true to your size, because I'm pretty sure I sized up because I'm a size 7, but I got a size 38. You can tell they're not the greatest quality, and the bottom isn't terribly squishy, so they're not gonna be super comfortable in that regard. Let me know what you guys think down below, what items you liked, maybe if you have opposing opinions to the items that I thought were cute or not cute. I'm really interested to hear what you have to say, so please let me know down below. Yeah, be sure to subscribe and then hit the bell button to be notified when I post a new video, and you can go ahead and follow my Instagram, it's at adventuro17. All the information that you will need for everything in this haul will be linked in the description box, as well as the code for 10% off of orders over $49. And if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up because it really does help me out. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!